Hi, this video episode will talk about FTTH testing procedures in preparation for final project acceptance. We will adapt how Globe Telecom Philippines implements their FTTH projects. The video will involve the presence of full turnkey vendor, which was HUAWEI Philippines and LASAYA RCA of Quezon City, being the subcontractor of the project. Let's understand first what FTTH network architecture does Globe Telecom Philippines follows. Most telecom in Philippines uses a cascaded or distributed splitting approach. This means there are two combinations of splitters used to reach a uniform count of lines per OLT port. The first level splitter is called LCP, or Local Convergence Point, and the second level splitter is called NAP, or Network Access Point. Globe Telecom uses dome splice closures to house their LCP. It contains two pieces of 1:4 splitters. NAP carries 1:8 splitter. It uses cabinet type enclosure. The cabinet type enclosure is only suitable for aerial application. For underground scenarios, dome type closure is used for NAP. By combining 1:4 split LCP and 1:8 NAP, we come up with 32 lines each OLT port. On the exchange side, there is 144 port OTF from which the 144 core feeder cable is terminated. LCP takes single core out from the feeder cable and is spliced to 1:4 splitter. The 4 pigtails out of the LCP will be then spliced to 4 cores among 72 core distribution cable, linking each NAP boxes. Out of that 4 core splits from the LCP, 1 core will be spliced to 1:8 splitter inside the NAP. For every 1 LCP, it can light up 4 units of 8 port NAP box. On project acceptance, testing demarcation point is at NAP ports, which is the home pass premise endpoint. We start our optical testing at the exchange site. Every port on the ODF is checked if the 144 feeder cable were terminated properly. If there were identified faulty port, troubleshooting is done. Using OTDR, it will show where the location of the loss is and will be rectified by the technicians on site. Common faults are high loss in adapters, high splash loss, and core assignment mismatch. If trouble was detected on the joint position or in any enclosure, a device called optical fiber identifier is used to determine the presence of light source flowing from a single fiber. This tool can measure how much light power is supplied from the source without breaking the fiber. We take note of the distances from OLT to NAP positions using OTDR. Test results are saved and will be submitted as one of the project acceptance requirements. OTDR is used as a light source for optical testing. Three test wavelengths were used, the 1310, 1490, and 1550 nanometers. OLT is using class B+ PON OSFP and can withstand up to negative 28 dB insertion loss. Based from the standards, acceptable optical power readings from NAP ports should reach a negative 25 dB loss below to have a negative 3 dB margin loss allowance. This margin loss is included on the link budget allocation for aging and maintenance losses that the ODN network might encounter in future. Insertion loss is calculated by the difference between light source power and the readings shown in the optical power meter measured from the NAP port. On the acceptance sheet form, optical power meter reading on all 8 ports of the NAP should be written within 2 trials. The acceptance form also required you to take note the distance measured from OLT to LCP and NAPs, naming convention of each splitters, pole number, NAP addresses, OLT and ODF port assignments, and central office name. Knockdown testing should be performed. This is done by removing power light source from OLT side while power meter remains on the NAP port. This is a confirmatory test whether OLT port assignment was followed correctly. Once every port assignment and test is set, tagging each patch cord is part of acceptance criteria. These patch cords are the interface between the feeder, ODF, and the OLT. Last testing to be done is the throughput testing. After configuring the OLT and the single unit ONT, a speed test is implemented to determine if it reaches the desired download and output speed. This test is done from the closest and furthest NAP. Once the FTK vendor and subcontractor confirms readiness of the FTTH project, they will call Globe Telecom for acceptance test. Three parties will be inspecting the project site and conducts physical testing and optical testing of the FTTH project. I hope I was able to give you knowledge about how FTTH testing done in Philippine settings. Thank you for watching.